Like, my own fucking son broke into his own fucking mom's house and stole 5 fucking TVs. That nigga stole 5 fucking TVs out of my fucking house in the last 2 days.
If your kid is gonna do some fuck shit like this, they are not going to do it like that, okay? It's not gonna be 0 to 100 real quick. They been like that. They been ain't shit. Your kid not just gonna be ain't shit today. Your kid just been ain't shit. Your kid probably been fucking stealing. Your kid probably been shoplifting. Your kid probably bad in school. Your kid probably been fighting. Your kid probably getting suspended. Your kid probably been in juvie a couple of times. Your kid is most likely always been the type of kid to be in that type of realm of ain't shitness, and most likely his friends were too.
They said that I guess
Mark. Hello?
I don't know. Hey, what's up?
So you said I stole your TVs and shit?
I don't even know who you are.
I don't got nothing to do with that because I'm on hospice.
Pop it up on the line while she talking shit. Hold up. Oh my god! My channel, and today we are going to be reacting to a mom dragging her son on Instagram Live for robbing her house. Now, I will say, out of all the videos that I have reacted to on this channel regarding parents, it's actually pretty rare to see a boy being dragged, especially a mom dragging her son. But this one will not include the child. It is literally a mom going off about how her son robbed her. I have not watched the video. I don't watch any of my videos ahead of time. However, judging by the comment section, the view count, and just the logistics of all of it, I can tell this is gonna be pretty interesting. Now, definitely comment down below if you've ever had your kid basically rob, steal, or like do anything crazy like this to you, or if you are a kid that has, you know, robbed or stolen from your parents, it's okay, it's a safe space. And for the most part, you may be helping out a kid out there that has done something like this or is thinking about doing something like this. This is a community where we like to help one another, give advice to one another so that other kids and other people don't do the same shit. I really think it's gonna be very interesting to see this because, let's be real here, a lot of parents are very, very biased when it comes to their sons, and they literally let their sons get away with bloody murder, especially when it comes to black parents. Like, I feel like a lot of people are very, very disproportionate in the way that they treat and punish their daughters versus their sons. So I found it interesting that I even found someone dragging their damn son. It's so hard to find these damn videos. So without further ado, let's get straight into the video. But of course, make sure you guys smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, smash every button that can help a sister out. As you guys see, the background is different. I did say on Instagram, if you're not following me on Instagram, please go do that. What is y'all doing? That I will be including things that you guys have sent me on this background. So it's gonna be changing ever so often. And I already have some things that you guys have sent me. Some of you guys may recognize it. Subscriber made this the Mademoiselle sign. You know, some things you guys have sent me over time. I'm gonna be putting up some letters and stuff like that. So yeah, if you guys wanna send me anything, I will have it on the screen. And if it's not on the screen, or if you missed it because your head is down, everything you need is always in the description box along with other information that you guys always ask me about. So let's get straight into the reaction.
Call your auntie, your cousins, your grandma, a motherfucking sister, a fake friend. I don't give a fuck. Call somebody. Like, my own fucking son broke into his own fucking mom's house and stole 5 fucking TVs. That nigga stole 5 fucking TVs out of my fucking house in the last 2 days. 5, y'all. 5 fucking TVs. This nigga steal from his own fucking mom. His own fucking mom. All my fucking life, I'm not making it up. When I tell you, I know that he got caught today with some niggas in a motherfucking stolen car. If any one of them motherfucking bastards had anything to do with coming into my fucking house, we got beef. Know that. Know that. You better go get a motherfucking adult. Because if I see any one of you fucking bastards with any fucking, my fucking shoes, my coat, anything that looks remotely close to anything that came out of my fucking house, bitch, I'm beating your fucking ass. A fucking kid, yes. I'm beating a kid's fucking ass. And I mean that shit. I mean that. When I tell you that I feel so fucking disrespected, I feel so motherfucking, like, I just never seen no shit like that before in my life. Who does...
All right. I got too much to say because there's too much to unpack here. First of all, within 2 days, I don't know if she was out of town for 2 days. How in the hell did he manage to steal all of that within 2 days and you just noticed? I don't understand. I'm just going to give her the benefit of the doubt there. Second of all, let's be real here. I'm going to just be 100% upfront and honest. How in the hell is your kid that fucking screwed up that they robbed from you? Like, nobody's kid is really gonna rob from you. Like, even these badass kids that I know, mind y'all, bro, I grew up in the hood. I know gangbangers. I know prostitutes. I know all types of fucking people. And never in my life have I heard of anybody robbing from their own parents. Okay, I've heard people robbing from their friends, robbing from their boyfriends, robbing from their husbands, their wives, and all types of shit. But robbing from their parents, that's something I never heard of. Also, let's be real. If your kid is gonna do some fuck shit like this, they're not going to do it like that, okay? It's not gonna be 0 to 100 real quick. They've been like that. They've been ain't shit. Your kid not just gonna be ain't shit today. Your kid just been ain't shit. Your kid probably been fucking stealing. Your kid probably been shoplifting. Your kid probably bad in school. Your kid probably been fighting. Your kid probably getting suspended. Your kid probably been in juvie a couple of times. Your kid is most likely always been the type of kid to be in that type of realm of ain't shitness, and most likely his friends were too. Okay, you sitting here talking about, oh well, I never seen no shit like this, I can't believe he did this. Yes you can, because more than likely he was not this amazing kid that was in the books studying all damn day, in his business, you know, staying in the house, you know, trying to get straight A's, and just got in the wrong crowd and now he's stealing from you. Let's be real. Kids that are doing things like this to this type of extreme have a legitimate problem and probably always been like this. They do not always end up just one day picking up they shit and disappearing, getting caught in a stolen car and robbing shit from their parents' house. I just don't understand why she's trying to act surprised. And I'm not trying to be an asshole here, but you knew your kid was gonna do some fuck shit like this and you just didn't expect it to be you. You expected it to be someone else. And I'm just gonna say that she's only mad because it's her house that's being robbed. But the problem I have with a lot of parents these days, especially black women, yes, I said what I said and I meant what I said, I'm gonna say it again. A lot of y'all let y'all sons get away with bloody fucking murder, okay? Y'all sons could do anything in the fucking world and y'all are not gonna say anything about it. Y'all will bat an eye. The cops will come looking for your son and y'all will hide your son under the floorboards, in the attic, underground railroad, bitch. Let y'all daughters do something. Officer, she's right over there. Y'all sons do something. I haven't seen him, officer. I don't know where my son is. Oh, my son would never. Let your daughter do something. Oh my God, I can't believe you did that. Oh, take her away from me. I'm so ashamed of you. A lot of you guys are protecting the misogyny, the patriarchy, the bullshit that y'all sons do. A lot of y'all protect the caca that these men do, and that's why a lot of these men refuse to change. Okay? That's why a lot of them are running amok in these streets. I said what I said, I meant what I said, and I'll say it again. And I really can't say I feel bad for her because I know damn well she knows how her son was. Ain't no fucking way this kid just came out swinging, acting like this. Out of nowhere with some straight A amazing ass kid, and then now he wanna rob shit and get caught in stolen cars with his little dusty ass friends. Ain't no way. Also, why instead of calling the police are you on the internet? Why? You don't care that much about your shit. And for a lot of people that are probably like, why would she call the cops on her own son? You don't care about your shit then. What is these people on the internet gonna do? Comment down below. For anyone that's thinking that it's wrong to call the cops on your kids, what are the people on the internet gonna do? Nothing! Why in the hell are y'all sitting here talking shit on the internet about your kids as if they're going to do something for you. All of these people are in this live like, oh, you want me to do something to them for you? Like, y'all need to stop this, because all this is going to do is provoke violence, because that's the only thing they can really do, right? They're going to just probably find these kids and probably do something fucked up to them, and then it's going to create a cycle that you didn't want to start. So realistically speaking, I have no idea why the fuck she's speaking. If anything, she should just be speaking to the cops so they can find these fucking kids. So, I mean, I think they already got caught, right? Didn't she say they got caught, like, in like, you know, a stolen car or whatever? But, like, I just don't understand. She should be pressing charges so that kid could learn a fucking lesson. Yes, I said what the fuck I said. Like, I'm the type of person where, let my kid steal, let my kid do some shit like that, nigga, you going to the police, okay? You going to jail for the night. I don't give a fuck. You gonna learn today. I ain't gonna leave them in jail for like a month. But no. And no. Like, I'm just that type of person. I believe in lessons and I believe in consequences. I believe in people legitimately getting what they're supposed to get for the things that they do. There's good consequences, there's bad consequences. And whatever consequence you get is the consequence you get. Okay? I'm gonna tell y'all a short little story time. Okay? Throughout the, probably after this, after we watch a little bit more of this, because y'all gonna see what I mean. I do not play that shit. Okay? You gonna get what you get. You won't learn, okay? So.
Their fucking mom like that. Who does their fucking mom like that? My own fucking son broke into my fucking house and stole my fucking TVs.
This is sad.
5 TVs for me. 5. Now, if that ain't some motherfucking, like, that's different for me. That's different to me. Because I, listen, when I tell you that I cannot believe that my own fucking son would do me like that, and I swear to God, them motherfucking, I welcome every single one of his motherfucking friends into my fucking house. These niggas done spent the night over here. I done fed these niggas. I done gave these niggas rides, all that shit. He had fucking help. There's no way that he could have took the motherfucking TVs out of my fucking house without help. He had help. But it's a coincidence that and a couple of his other little dusty ass friends got caught today in a stolen fucking car. How is that a coincidence? And these are the same niggas that have been in my house. The same niggas who have spent the night at my house. When I tell you I'm not letting this go, I'm not letting it go when I tell you I will beat a kid's fucking ass. Go get your fucking weak ass, bum ass fucking mom. Go get your weak ass, bum ass motherfucking whoever the fuck you want a motherfucking, whoever wants to get involved, get an adult involved.
It's the threats for me. It's the threats in the chat. It's the threats from the mom. It's just very unnecessary and very unsettling. And if something were to happen, I don't know, this was over a year ago. I'm gonna peep the comments again just in case, but like, this is actually very yikes.
You don't do your fucking family like that. You don't do your fucking mom like that. Like, who the fuck does that? Like, who does that? That nigga broke into his mom's house. Like, nigga, you wanna be in a fucking weak ass gang that you're not even really in that bad to prove some shit to some people who are fucking irrelevant?
I guess she kind of shed some light there. So she said that, you know, he wants to be in a gang, so that's probably why he did it. That actually kind of makes more sense here. All right. I wouldn't be surprised, because that is very excessive. Stealing from your mom and then stealing 5 TVs at that. But my thing is, if you as a mom know that this might be a reason and you're so definitive, like the way she's talking, like she kind of seems like she knows, why would you allow him to hang out with these kids?
Like, yo, when I tell you that my fucking feelings are so motherfucking hurt that I'm trying to calm myself down, because when I tell you, I just feel so fucking violated. You know what I mean? I just feel so fucking violated. Like, man, I just cannot believe that he would do me so fucking dirty. Like, I just cannot believe that my own fucking son would do me like that, man. Like, when I tell y'all that that nigga has stole money from me, that nigga has done so many things for me, but this right here was the straw that broke the camel's back.
Your son has stolen money from you, and you don't think he will steal things from your house?
Like, 5 fucking TVs. 5.
No logic.
And my fucking tennis shoes. And my goddamn coat. Like, that's crackhead shit to me. Nigga, you on drugs?
He stole those TVs to crackheads.
Man, like, and I'm only going live on Demir stuff because there's no other way for me to get this out there.
Like, I swear to God, man, like, I don't give a fuck. Everything that I fucking say on this live, I mean that shit to my fucking soul. The fuck? I'm old school. Like, I'm old school and I got bomb money. Like, know that. I got bomb money. I don't give a fuck. Do your weak ass mom or your weak ass bum ass motherfucking mom got motherfuckers gonna come for y'all? Hell no. The fuck? I'm down for this nigga and this nigga still shits on me. Still shits on me. The fuck?
And that's because that's the generation that we're in, man. That's the motherfucking shit. That's the that's what's wrong with these fucking kids. There's no fucking honor. There's no respect. There's no shit. Like, I'm telling
you. I'm sorry. You raised him. Y'all raised this generation. You have no room to talk. And you have no room to complain. Therefore, when you talk about this generation, you are looking in the mirror, my friend. I have absolutely no idea why these adults, okay, these grown adults be complaining about kids that they raised. Congratulations, you played yourself. Your son robbed you, you're mad, and now you're talking shit about us. You talking shit about this generation. Congratulations, you played yourself. Nothing to do with the generation. That's your fault. That's your problem. Okay? Now call the renter's insurance, which I hope you got. House insurance, whatever. Some type of insurance that I hope you got. Because the fuck, that has nothing to do with us. Like,
they said that, I guess, Mark.
Hello?
I don't know. Hey, what's up?
So you said I stole your TVs and shit?
I don't even know who you are.
I don't got nothing to do with that because I'm on hospice.
Wait, not one of the people that she's accusing popping up on the line while she talking shit. Hold up. Oh my god!
Somebody sent me this watch and I said, I stole your TV.
No, I don't know.
Hey, hold on.
Only people that have ever been in my house.
What, so they stole your TVs?
No, I don't know. Only thing I'm saying is it's a coincidence that my TVs came up missing today, right? So my four TVs came up missing today. Got caught in a stolen car with fucking three other dudes today. So my thing is,
he was with.
That's what I'm saying. I don't know who he was with.
Oh, that's the fourth person. Oh,
but I just know that he didn't act alone. There's footprints outside in the snow. He didn't do that by himself.
So somebody go in your house and steal your TVs?
So they stole 5 TVs in the last 2 days.
Ma'am, is it 4 or 5? Am I the only one that noticed that the whole time? Is it 4 or 5? Make up your mind.
Oh, he brave. Well, I was just saying on her because somebody said that I was a part of that shit. I don't know
who you are. I've never seen you before. I don't even know. I don't know who you are. I've never seen you before. I'm speaking about the dudes who have came to my house and have spent the night with, like, they just spent the night over here. Like, I done fed these niggas. I done gave them rides.
Shut up. Now, like, this is the thing, right? If you guys don't know anything about hood culture, being a snitch is one of the worst things that you could really be. Y'all know I be joking around all the time. I'm like, yo, I'm a snitch. But like, I really don't be sitting here doing that. But for the most part, I will say that I'm not about to throw my ass under the bus for you. And I'm most importantly not about to literally ruin my life for your ass. And I'm gonna tell y'all my little story before we watch the rest of this, because this is a very long story. I mean, this is a very long reaction. So I hope you guys have your food and your snacks and all of that. So long story short, one day I had a friend, okay, and one day me and my two friends, we decided to go shopping, right? And one of these stores, and we walked into one of these stores, and this was a very cheap store. Like, it was one of those stores that like nothing in there cost more than like $40. So my friend saw these jeans and they had to be like $20, okay? And she was like, yo girl, I really like these jeans, I really want them. I'm like, okay, then buy them. And she's like, I don't think I should have to pay for these. And I'm like, why do you think you don't have to pay for them? She's like, well, I don't think they're worth $20. I'm like, then don't get them. She was like, no, but I really want them. And I'm like, well, I don't know. And she's like, well, you're the only one that has a purse. Cause like at this time I was like one of those like people, like I really loved carrying bags. I hate carrying bags now cause I have a car, but before I was always carrying a bag and they didn't have a bag. And she's like, well, give me your purse so I can steal these jeans. And I'm looking at her like, so you're really gonna steal these jeans instead of just paying $20 for them, which you have. And she's like, yeah. I was like, if you steal these jeans, you're on your own. And she was like, so y'all really not gonna leave here with me? I'm like, I swear to God, you steal those jeans, I'm not doing shit with you ever again. Like, and you're gonna walk through those doors by yourself. She's like, wow, you really think I'm gonna get caught? I said, I know you're gonna get caught, and I really don't give a fuck what happens to you, and I kid you not, I will act like I do not know you. And she literally took my purse, she put the jeans in there, she tried to walk through the door, she clearly got caught. And literally they're taking pictures of her, because you know how a lot of stores, like if you get caught stealing, they take your picture, they put it on the wall, cops come and everything, handcuff her. It was a whole ordeal. And I straight up walked to the back where she was getting her pictures done and getting fingerprinted, all that bullshit. And I was like, hello, can I have my purse? And they were like, oh, this is your purse? I'm like, yeah, that's my purse. I collected my bag from them, and they were just like, I'm like, the fuck, I didn't steal the fuck, you won't give me my damn bag back. And like, she was like, wow. I'm like, I don't give a fuck. That's you. Consequences, okay? Actions get consequences. You gotta learn your fucking lesson, okay? At the end of the day, you wanna do fuck shit, you're gonna do fuck shit by your damn self, okay? I'm not gonna sit there and go down with you, okay? This no snitch culture or whatever is actually very, very toxic. But at the end of the day, that's just what it is. If you snitch, you really might be setting yourself up for failure, and you really might just die. So what she's doing right here, she's really just setting her son up for failure, in terms of like, now when he fucks around and tries to have friends or tries to get into any other situations, they're gonna look at her son as like, you know, a snake or like a rat, you know, because it's gonna look like, oh wow, if you steal from your mom, that means you gonna steal from anybody, you know, that means you a snitch, you a this, you a that. In this case, I just let her do what she do. I ain't gonna tell on you, but you wanna use my purse to steal, that's fine. I went up to the cops and I was like, that's my purse, thank you, and I left the fuck. And funny enough, she actually ended up spending a couple hours in jail. Her parents bailed her out or came to get her, whatever, but they let her walk straight home from the precinct that day. And she lived pretty damn far from the precinct because consequences, okay? Bad actions have bad consequences. All actions have consequences, but for that one, she got a bad consequence. Don't nobody got time for that bullshit. Like, this bitch was sitting here doing all of this goofy shit over $20 jeans, and I let her walk her goofy ass to that door and get caught. I ain't have to snitch on her. She did that to herself, okay? So in those type of situations, you let people do stupid shit on their own, okay? And honestly, in this situation, she should just let her son do goofy shit on his own. She's doing way too damn much. Like, this is just, why didn't she just report this man? I don't know. Like, this is too much now. Now it's getting to be like, oh my God. Like, now that there's a whole nother person on this live, like, oh God.
So he in JVC right now? He in JDC right now?
No, that nigga is not in nothing.
Well, so he's not even in jail.
He's not even in jail. No, that nigga be lying, y'all. I'm telling you, he be lying.
Who the fuck? Break up that nigga. Why would you do something like that? I didn't do that.
Like, that shit is lit. Yeah, like, he ain't in no fucking jail.
Not yet.
He's never been in jail.
No, that nigga's never been to jail. That nigga, when he was posting all that shit, Free Dodo and all that shit, he was in a foster home.
Oh.
That nigga was in a foster home.
He should be in jail.
Never been in jail. Never in his life.
Should be. All this shit you say he done to you.
Wrong, man.
I'ma just spare y'all the time and the nonsense. The mom is sitting here just dragging her son, telling all his secrets, calling him a fraud. And I think this is just really unnecessary and ridiculous. I understand that she's mad. I understand that he stole. I understand that clearly he's on the path to doing a lot more worse. But this is so ridiculously unnecessary that I don't even understand how this is going to get any of her TVs back. And I don't understand how this is going to prevent him from doing worse to her in the future. Oh, this is a waste of my fucking time. I really don't even think I care. I think I'm just going to skip through this bullshit. Like, is there anybody else going to come on this? Like, I'm just so annoyed. Like, oh my God.
Donovan's only 14. Donovan just turned 14. Like, there ain't no way he can know Drizzy.
14? Apparently, this kid is only 14. And this is what he's doing. I'm thinking this kid is 16, 17, 18. If he's 14 and he's stealing money from you, he's disrespecting you, and he's already burglarizing your home, he's literally on the road to America's Most Wanted. To be quite honest with you, I don't even understand why the hell your first inclination is to talk shit on Facebook Live or Instagram Live. Your first thought should be bringing him on Beyond Scared Straight or whatever the fuck. This is ridiculous as hell. Like, no. Instagram is not gonna cut it. That shit just pissed me off right now. I did not know this kid was this goddamn young. What? 14? If y'all don't nip this shit in the butt, the kid is going to be in jail in the next year or two.
If my older son, you know, put his hands on, get himself caught up in some shit, you know what I mean? That's my son's in college. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not trying to put him in no type of situation like that. You know what I mean? I feel like let's take it to the streets. I'm going to get one of y'all to beat his ass. I'm going to pay one of y'all to beat his ass. And I mean that shit, man. Like, you just don't fucking do your mom like that. Not no mom like me.
So you're okay with getting someone else's child, not your kid, to put hands on your kid for justice. Meanwhile, you never took matters into your own hand with parenting your kid the right way so that they didn't do this bullshit. What she just said was the most ridiculous, disgusting, and horrible thing ever. That is just ass backwards. To be honest with you, this video was just a fucking headache. I had to skip around. I had to cut so much out. I personally don't think that you guys should even waste your time trying to watch the whole thing, but I definitely will link it down below. I'm not even gonna waste my time watching the rest of it because I think I lost so many brain cells watching this. I'm about to go read a book after this bullshit. Honestly, like, it's just, I don't even want to read the comments. I don't give a fuck if she got the TVs back. I don't even want to know what happened to her son. I don't want to know what happened to the rest of the people. I don't want to know who the fuck helped him, because I think that this mom is just a waste of fucking time. I mean, hopefully and thankfully, it sounds like one of her sons ended up decent, because I mean, he's in college. But I mean, just because your kid's in college doesn't mean you're a good parent. But like, it's just, I'm just so fucking disappointed in this right now. Like, this was just the most ghetto, ratchet, disgusting, ridiculous shit I've ever watched in my entire life. Realistically, if she really cared about her kid, if she really cared about her possessions, she would have nipped his behavior in the butt a long time ago. He is way too young to be exhibiting that type of behavior at such a young age. And if she really cared about her shit and how he was acting, she would actually try to either get him some therapy, try to sit him down, and actually go out and try to find where he was at, instead of getting on the internet and literally entertaining little ass fucking kids. Like, after a while, it just looked like she was entertaining these kids. Like, it looked like she was just fucking, like, enjoying this. Like, sitting there talking to little ass kids, talking about, yeah, I'm gonna get one of y'all to be his ass. Yeah, like, oh my God, like, yeah, like, he a punk. Like, yeah, he a snitch. Like, you know, if he could do this to me, then that mean, you know, he just a punk. Like, yeah, he had it. Like, it looks like she was just getting off on that. And honestly, not impressed, not entertained. Very thoroughly drained from that nonsense. With that being said, comment down below, what do you guys think about that video? What do you guys think? Do you actually think her son actually went and stole all of that shit in the house? Do you guys think that she's over exaggerating and she was just putting the blame on her son? Do you think it was the son and the friends? Just let me know all your thoughts and opinions down below. Basically, I want to know. I really want to know what you guys think. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, peep the description box for all the information. Follow me on Instagram. It's right on the screen. And yeah, I'm gonna see you guys next time. Make sure you guys go subscribe to my Haitian channel, get your merchandise, and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye.